In this problem, we're told that we're pulling a block out from under another block. So we have this big block on the bottom and we're trying to slide that out from under this 2.5 kilogram block that sits on top of it. And that 2.5 kilogram block is not going to go along because it's being held in place with this string. And we're told the string has a breaking strength of 16 newtons. So that's the maximum tension you can get to before the string will snap. So the question asks us for the maximum coefficient of static friction between the blocks so that the string doesn't break when we pull out the lower block. So we imagine for the moment the system is completely stationary, but we're pulling on that lower block. And there's a rough texture on the top of that block and it's locked into a rough texture on the bottom of the top block. So that bottom block is pulling to the left on the 2.5 kilogram block. That's the static friction force, provided nothing starts slipping. So there's our static friction force and we're going to call that Fs. So what happens as we pull harder and harder on this lower block is that we're creating a bigger and bigger leftward static friction force on our upper block, but is not moving because the tension in the string keeps growing to balance that static friction force and hold the block in place. So there's the tension pulling to the right on this block. Again, this is a completely static problem. So we can say that the static friction force on the 2.5 kilogram block is equal to that tension pulling to the right. Now what we want is for our block to begin slipping right as we're getting to 16.0 newtons. So we're pushing it as far as we possibly can, close to the breaking strength of the string without actually breaking it. So what I want is for my static friction force to be at its maximum value. That means just about to break loose, right when my tension in the string is 16.0 newtons. And our little formula that we have describing static friction in terms of a friction coefficient, that's a formula for the maximum value of static friction. That's given by mu s times the normal force. So the static friction is variable up to this maximum amount. The harder and harder we pull on that bottom block, the static friction grows, and then it gets to this maximum amount given by mu s times the normal force. So it looks like we need to find the normal force on this block. And for that, we have to put our vertical vectors into the diagram. So there's the force of gravity pulling down with a magnitude of mg, and there's the normal force pushing up on this block to balance the vertical forces. So there's nothing else tampering with the vertical direction, and we can immediately tell the normal force is given by mg. We'll go ahead and calculate this thing right in the diagram. So I have a mass of 2.5 kilograms. G is about 9.8 meters per second squared. And so it turns out the normal force is 24.5 newtons. So we go ahead and plug this in and we get that mu s times 24.5 newtons is equal to 16.0 newtons. And we're going to keep three significant digits on our final answer for mu s. That's 16 divided by 24.5. And we get 0.653 for our coefficient of static friction. And this is going to make it so we get right up to that breaking strength of 16.0 newtons in the string, right when the thing breaks loose, and we'll be able to pull out the big block from underneath the 2.5 kilogram block. If you enjoyed this video, or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left, or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.